A very good morning. You are watching New Vision TV News around Uganda. I am Ruthina Seje, and here we look at stories making headlines across the country. We kickstart off to this bulletin from Wakiso District. The government has been urged to channel youth funds meant for empowering young people through the Youth Livelihood Program to vocational school graduates. The State Minister for Primary Education, Rosemary Seninde, made the call on Thursday during the second graduation of the women and youth in Wakiso District at Nambole Stadium. The ceremony was organized by the Seninde Foundation under the theme Skilling Wakiso District. A total of 3,489 students were awarded certificates in bakery and catering, hairdressing, fashion, design and tailoring, charcoal and briquettes making. Moving on to Kavalori District, the King of Toro, Oyo Nyimba Kabamba Iguru, has called on all his subjects to embrace the blood donation campaign so as to bridge the gap of blood shortage in the country. Oyo made the call during the Kingdom Supreme Council sitting at Mutua Kingdom Parliament last week. Oyo also called for a strong partnership between the central government and the kingdom in promoting the quality of healthy services. The King commended the continued improvement in the primary living examination results, where Fort Portal has over the years been among the top performing municipalities. And news coming in from Mayuge District, parents in Bunya East constituency have resolved to carry out door-to-door sensitization campaigns, among other strategies to improve the education standards in the area. The parents admitted that the poor performance among pupils in last year's primary leaving examinations was a result of the laxity in ensuring routine school attendance and giving less support to children while at school. The parents were speaking during the consultative meeting organized by Bunya East Member of Parliament Wayura Chiwalabye Majegere at Mpungwe Primary School in Mpungwe Sub-County, Mayugwe District on Friday. And news coming in from Jinja District, the construction of the 11.6 billion shillings World Bank funded road in Jinja Town has been hampered by a railway crossing. The 1.9 kilometer roadworks, which was awarded by the Lebanese firm of Stars Group Engineering Limited, was scheduled to be completed in June. It is funded by the World Bank under the Uganda Support Municipal Infrastructure Development Program and supervised by the Minister of Lands, Housing and Urban Development. The road stretches from the police roundabout on Engineer Zikusoka way up to Jinja Main Street at Tropical Bank. Much as the constructor has completed 80% of the works on the drainage system, the remaining part has hit a snag due to the railway crossing. According to Stars Group's Managing Director, Engineer Ali Al Atrash, the said spot was a hindrance to their schedule. And from Budaka District, the police and other security personnel have beefed up deployment at Limoto Swamp following renewed clashes between the Bagwere and the Banyole over the boundary separating Budaka and Butaleja districts. According to Sowali Kamulia, the Bukedi Region Police spokesperson, three detaches have been reinforced at the boundary, with more forces expected in the area. Kamulia said the development for the Friday incident in which residents of Budaka destroyed gardens in Butaleja. On Saturday morning, the residents of Butaleja retaliated by destroying several acres of crops. And from Sorority District, Humanity First Uganda, a UK-based charity organization, has donated scholastic materials at St. Francis Secondary School for the blind Madeira in Sorority District. The donated items include 100 boxes of Braille paper and footballs aimed at boosting the academic performance of students with disabilities. Rashid Ahmed Neved, the director of the organization, noted the program is a worldwide project targeting students in over 50 countries. He said the motive is to promote and safeguard life and dignity irrespective of race, gender, religion and political affiliation. And that's all we had for you. Thank you for watching. Be sure to catch more news updates and other programs here on New Vision TV by visiting our website www.newvision.co.ug. I am Ruth Nasejeb.